guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Emily and this is seriously our first 2018 video. I am 3 days late, but that's okay. We're still here, positive, healthy, and all that good stuff. All right, so before we get into this video, I just want to say Happy New Year's to everybody, and I hope this year brings nothing but positivity and abundance in every way, money, health, just in any freaking way you need it or want it. I just hope this year brings it to you and to me too, because come on, I need some abundance in my life because 2017 really sucked the life out of me. I'm gonna show you guys first, it's my skincare routine, which is gonna be really straightforward, and from there we'll jump to the few advices that I have for you guys that I feel like will help you guys achieve a clearer skin or just lower your chances of having breakouts. Because when I wasn't doing these things that I'm about to show you, my skin was just not cooperating. It wasn't doing what I was expecting it to do, even though I have my skincare routine. And I feel like a lot of people don't do these things, and if you don't do these things, it doesn't care how much you're cleaning it, exfoliating, toning it, whatever. If you don't do those tips, you're not gonna get the results that you want. So yeah, let's just get right into this.
All right, so I'm gonna start off by showing you guys my first tip, and this is pretty straightforward, and it's washing your hands before washing your face. All right, so next I'll be taking the Caldali Paris Cleansing Water Maker Removal, and then taking exfoliating pad, spraying some of that in that, and removing my makeup. I love this makeup removal. Even though it's a little expensive, it does its job quick and effortlessly. I could just use one pad and I'll just remove my whole makeup. The only downside I gotta say is that it burns your eyes, but I feel like every makeup removal does that. But other than that, this makeup removal is amazing. So next I'll be taking my Venecia Soapworks Pure Vegetable Soap with Lemon. As you can see, the box is all messed up because that's my holy grail and I use it all the time. Then I'll be taking this $1 exfoliating brush that I got from Walmart, rub some soap on it, and then exfoliating my face. To be honest, if you've watched my previous videos where I mentioned this soap, you know that this is my go-to. I've been using it for the past 2 years and it's the only thing that has given me results other than any other product that I've used. And it's just amazing. And this voiceover is hard to do. Like, this is my first time ever doing voiceovers and I'm just not good at this at all. All right, so I just rinse my face and then go back with the soap and actually wash my face with my hands and remove any makeup that was left from my makeup removal, since like I said before, the makeup removed those from my eyes. So I'm not always able to get all the makeup off my eyes and then rinse that off. So next, I'll just dry my face with a towel that's just strictly for my face. I don't use this towel for nothing else but just to dry my face. All right, so the last step is moisturizing. I told you guys my routine is super short and I use the Clinique Turnaround Overnight, and I apply that on my face, on the driest parts of my face, because I do have a combination of dry and oily skin. But in the winter, my skin tends to be a little more dry than usual. So I just apply that all over my face. And I do repeat this routine twice a day. So that means I do it in the morning and at night. And this is every day. Like, I never ever take a break with my routine. All right, so we just got to the fun part where I'm gonna show you guys how to clean your brushes with items that you have somewhere around your house. All right, so the first item we're gonna need is a jar or a container. Here I'm using a mason jar because nobody uses it in the house. After, we're gonna need hair conditioner, any type of conditioner. I feel like every girl has this at their house, it's a must. And also we need dish soap, any type of dish soap, does not matter, whatever you have in the house, use that. And also we're gonna need some napkins because we're gonna have to dry our brushes into some. Alright, so what you're gonna do is just pump some conditioner into the jar like I'm doing, and after, just take your dish soap and also pump it into the jar or the container, whatever you have, and just take your brush and just clean it. You mix the liquids and just seriously clean it. Seriously, this is so easy and it's not gonna cost you anything because this you have somewhere around your house. And as you can see already the makeup just coming off. It looks disgusting, but seriously, I saw this video, like this tip, I think on Facebook once, and since then I've been using this And instead of me wasting money on makeup removal, which costs like $8, I just do this at home and save myself some bucks. It's quick and easy. All right, so after this is where the napkin comes in for, and it's for you to brush off the excess, and just after that, just let your brush just dry and it'll look just brand new. The reason why I'm sharing this is because I know a lot of girls do not clean their makeup brushes, and yo, the importance of your brushes being clean is just beyond, because your brushes, if your brushes are not clean, you're gonna break out. No matter how amazing your skincare routine is, your brushes will make you break out if they're dirty. And I'm showing this also because it's cheap. Like, you have all these items laying around your house. There's just no way you don't have these items in your house. And like that, you can save money and you can keep your brushes clean and you can keep your face clean from breaking out. So it's a win-win. You know, pocket wins, your face wins. My next advice is with the pillowcases. You should be changing your pillowcases at least every 2 weeks, because you do transfer dirt and all the other stuff to your pillows, which later transfer to your skin, which leads to breakouts. So if you want to avoid breakouts, you should be changing your pillowcases at least every 2 weeks. All right, guys, so my last advice is sleeping with your hair down. That is a no. Don't sleep with your hair down. Before you go to sleep, put your hair in a ponytail or a bun, whatever is more comfortable for you. But your hair does have these oils that transfers to your skin when you're sleeping, if you sleep with your hair down, and that leads to breakout. If you didn't know, now you know. Don't sleep with your hair down. It's just not good for your face at all.
So that's all for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video because I really took my time with it. It's almost 12, I think. Yeah, it's almost 12 at night, and I'll have to edit this video, which means I'm gonna go to sleep super late. But it's all for you guys, seriously. I wanted to share my skincare routine and the few tips that I show you guys for so long because they have been working for me. Obviously, I'm not gonna achieve the perfect clear skin when naturally my body, I have pro acne skin. It's something that I've learned to control it and make it less of it. And sometimes I do be having the clear, beautiful skin. Other times, like this month, I do have a little breakouts, but that's nothing crazy, you know, nothing. And I hope that you guys do take those advices and maybe add it to your routine. And if it does help, let me know. Like, don't be hesitant. Just really hit me up privately or just comment below if it does work for you. And if you have anything different from mine as well, you could definitely share that with me. I'll be glad to try new things for my skin. And yeah, that's all. So yeah, let me just not talk so much and just close this video up. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.